Welcome back, amigos and amigals, to a brand new Nerd DIY. I am so excited to finally do something Splatoon related. Let me know if you guys play Splatoon in the comments below. And if you play a particular character in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, also comment down below and it might be featured in the next Nerd DIY. So let's get this tutorial started. It is very easy, guys. All you have to do is print out an image of the Splatoon logo, which you can find on the internet. Just Google Splatoon icon, Super Smash Bros., and it should pop right up. After printing that out, grab your tracing paper and begin to place the dots. Start off with the major points of the image and then go ahead and space out the rest of the dots. I tend to just eyeball everything, but if you want to be on the safe side, I will provide a link down below in the description for a grid sheet, which is very, very helpful. In fact, all the materials used in this video will be down below in the description, so make sure you guys check it out. This is definitely one of the most technical images I've used for nail board art. So when it comes to curves like this, you actually have to place the nails very close together. Otherwise, you're not going to get that curvature. So let's just say that you don't have grid paper, you can definitely use a ruler or a flat sheet of paper. Both will definitely help, but I still highly suggest that you use a transparent grid sheet. It is definitely a lot easier and it helps so much. So again, all the materials will be down below in the description to make any type of nail board art. If you have a specific character that you want me to make sure you comment down below so I can include your comment in the next video. And of course, if you make any nerd DIYs, make sure you send pictures to me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. I would love to share it with all the amiibros out there. And of course, I'll post it in the next video. After you're done taping down your transparent paper onto the wooden board, it's time to bring out your nails. The type of nails that we'll be using are wire nails, and of course they will be down below in the description. You can use any type of color, gold, silver, even copper. They are available, and again, I'll have all those colors down below. So make sure that it matches your image and be creative. You can even use different types of nails and styles. Definitely go to Home Depot, look through those aisles, and find the right one. Alright, so when it comes down to actually hammering the nail, you want to make sure that it has a flat head so it keeps all that yarn together. And of course, you want to make sure that you have a steady hand. Please do not hammer the nail through the board. I've definitely done that several times, although you could cover the back with felt. It just saves you a lot of time if you're very careful and just be aware of your strength. If the nail happens to be out of place, you can always hit it on the sides too to make it aligned with the rest of the image. So don't worry if it's kind of wonky, you can definitely fix it. If you're not old enough to use the hammer, please, please ask your siblings or your parent to help you out. Of course, it is a very dangerous tool and yes, you can hit your fingers. I've done it so many times, so please be very careful. Once you're done removing the transparent paper off of the board, it's time to grab your yarn. I decided to go with colors that were dark, such as dark blue, gray, and white. But of course, this is your very own project, so be creative, use whatever colors you want. You can even go with the traditional Splatoon colors, such as bright pink or neon green. Just have fun, be creative, and of course, don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more nerd DIYs. All right, so actually placing the yarn onto the board is really fun. However, there are several tips that you need to keep in mind. So the first is actually outlining the image. You want to make sure that it stands out. So do that first, and then also do that last. As you can see here, when I reach a certain point, I'll loop it around on the edge and then proceed to fill in the whole image. Make sure that you go crazy and you try to fill in as many gaps that you see. So try different angles, different lengths to make sure that you cover those gaps and the image looks very full. Once in a while, you also want to push down the yarn that you place already on the nails so you have more room. You can further customize this board art by deciding what yarn to use. So if you notice, the gray yarn that I'm using is actually super fluffy, and I wanted to use that on the eyes just because I knew it would cover so much more of the board. And when it comes to eyes, that stands out the most. One of my all-time favorite parts of this whole entire project was actually going to my craft store and deciding which yarn to use. There was aisles of different types of yarn, some small, thin, flat, fluffy, so many, so that is why I love making nail board art. Let me know if there's a different character that I should make next time. And of course, check out all my other nerdy DIYs on my channel. Make sure you subscribe. If you make any nerd DIYs, definitely send me pictures on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. I am really active on those accounts. So again, all those links will be down below in the description, including all the materials used in this video. So if you want to make your own nail board art, it doesn't have to be Splatoon related. Whatever image you practically find on the interwebs is whatever you can use. Check out my other nail board art. I might have already made your favorite character from Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, so definitely check out the rest of the videos on my channel. Several shoutouts to these very crafty Amiibros. They are so amazing, and look how cool these turned out. Thank you so much for trying my nerd DIYs. It means the absolute world to have your support. So thank you again, Amiibros and Amigals, for being creative with me. Thank you so much for joining me on this new Nerd DIY. I do appreciate every single one of you guys. Thank you so much. Don't forget to like and subscribe to this video. Share it with your friends if you want to make your own art. And again, thank you for subscribing. Check out the links down below in the description, and I will definitely see you next time.